Matthew continues, "Verily I say to you," Mark chapter 9, verse 1, "And he said to them, Verily I say to you," Luke 9, 27, "But I tell you of a truth, verily is underlined in Matthew and Mark, both meaning truly." So I think that's just what Luke is saying, of a truth. Instead of saying, "but I tell you verily," or "verily I tell you," it's of a truth. I don't know if I should put them both. I think I could. It's not repeating the same word. And I do want to go with "but I tell you" instead of just I say. "But I say to you," tell you. Huh. I can go with "but verily." Yeah, that'd be the best. So Luke first. But now Matthew and Mark. Actually, I should start with Mark. "And he said to them," yeah, "verily." "Verily I say," or "I tell." I is all three. Matthew and Mark have "say" instead of "tell," so I'll just go with that. Majority witness. Since I'm going to "say," I'll have "to" as well. "To" and "you" is all three. And then I do want to add Luke, "of a truth." "Of a truth." "There be some standing here." Mark. "That there be some of them that stand here." "To that." Matthew. "There be some standing here." "There be some standing here." Matthew and Luke are the exact same. "There be some standing here." "That there be some." I think I can put the first "that," "that there be some," and I think I'll also add "of them." But instead of that second "that," I'll just go with "standing here." So it'll say, "But verily I say to you of a truth, that there be some of them standing here." Now that of them, that's annoying. Because he's speaking to them. So why would he say, when he's speaking to them, "there are some of them"? It's like he's talking to a third party. "There be some of them that are still going to be here until the kingdom of God comes in power." If I leave it out, it would be more the style from Matthew and Luke. They're both the same. "There be some standing here." Not "there be some of them," or "of those," or "of you standing here." But he goes on later, "till they see the Son of Man coming." Till they have seen the Son of Man come. Till they. So, it really is like he's talking to a third party now, but I'll just keep it. But I will have that first "that" from Mark. That. Gray. "There be some." standing here. Standing here, Matthew and Luke. Well, first of them. Of them. Now. That. I'm going to skip that and just have standing. Stand is from all three. Matthew, Luke have the ing. Here is also in Mark. Luke, which shall not taste of death. Mark, which shall not taste of death. Matthew, which shall not taste of death. Okay. Which shall not taste of death. Till they see the Son of Man. Till they have seen the kingdom of God. That's Mark. Till they see the kingdom of God. Huh. That's strange. Mark and Luke are saying kingdom. Instead of the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Till they see. Till they have seen. Till they. Okay, so till they is all three. Till they see. See. Or have seen. You know, none of them die because they've seen the transfiguration. That's what this is talking about. The very next thing recorded in Mark and in Matthew and in Luke is the transfiguration. That is what he's talking about. None of them die for that, so it doesn't make sense for him to say, which shall not taste death till they see. You won't taste death until you see the transfiguration. So when you see the transfiguration, you're going to die, or you're going to taste death. I know that's not what it really says, but it kind of leans that way. I think the way Mark has it, even though he's the only one that says it this way, till they have seen, that seems better. I'm going to go with that. It's an added word, so I usually keep all the added words anyway. See is part of seen, so I'll say that. If I was doing it the other way, I wouldn't say seen is part of see, because that's different tense. Have seen the kingdom of God come with power. No mention of the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. They just say the kingdom of God come with power. It's as if it has nothing to do with him in Mark. Matthew, it's all about him until they see the Son of Man. He's constantly calling himself the Son of Man, coming in his kingdom. Luke, till they see the kingdom of God. So it's like Mark, the kingdom of God come with power, except without come with power. So Mark and Luke are the most similar. The Son of Man coming in his kingdom. So they see the kingdom of God. It would sound weird if I said, till they have seen the Son of Man coming in the kingdom of God. Would it? It would definitely sound weird if it was the Son of Man coming in his kingdom of God. I'm not doing that. The Son of Man coming in the kingdom of God. Or maybe I can just have the kingdom of God come with power and the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. No, it's only one event. So they see the kingdom of God coming with power. Son of Man. The Son of Man coming in the kingdom of God. I think that's the best option I have to combine these two, but that really sounds strange. The Son of Man coming in the kingdom of God, as opposed to in his kingdom. Son of Man. Kingdom of God. The Son of Man coming in the kingdom of God. The Son of Man coming in his kingdom of God. His kingdom of God? No. Maybe I can go with the Son of Man coming and the kingdom of God come with power.